Hello and welcome back, dear students. Wish you all stay happy, healthy and safe at home and do your studies regularly and properly. I'm Yojana Parakh and today we are going to do a new chapter for standard 4 students from your English grammar textbook. The topic is degrees of comparison. So in today's video we are going to study about degrees of comparison. So first thing, for comparison we need some quality, and quality means adjectives. So comparison will be done between two nouns which are having common quality, and you can say which are having common adjective. So it is based upon adjectives. When comparison is done, that is called degree of comparison of adjective, and that comparison is done between two or more nouns. So that is what degree of comparison is. Now it is based upon adjectives, so it is the next step of adjective. Why degrees of comparison is used? For explaining the adjective more clearly and more emphatically. For example, if I say that this table is heavy, okay, we got the adjective that how the table is, it is heavy. But if I compare the table with another thing, that it is heavier than that table, that means the table has more weight. So the quality can be understood more clearly, and the adjective can be put emphatically by using degrees of comparison. So to express the quality of the noun more clearly and more emphatically, to emphasize on the adjective, we use degrees of comparison. Okay, so this is the next step of adjective. That is called degrees of comparison. Now let us see this topic in detail. Adjectives are describing noun. Adjectives are what? Which describes about noun. The describing word of noun is called adjective. We use adjectives in different forms to compare the two or more nouns. How we use these adjectives? We can use these adjectives even for comparison between two or more nouns. The different form of adjectives used to show the comparison are called degrees of comparison. The different forms of adjectives which are used for comparison, that is called degrees of comparison, degree of adjective of comparison. There are 3 degrees of comparison. First one is positive degree, second one is comparative degree, and third one is superlative degree. Okay, now what is positive degree, what is comparative degree, and what is superlative degree, that we will study in detail. So first thing is adjective that describe about noun. It can be used for comparison between two or more nouns. When we use the adjective for comparison, the form of adjective changes, and that is called degrees of comparison. In that, how the form of adjective will change and what are the degrees, how can you identify those degrees and how can you make the changes in the adjective, that we will learn in detail. So let us move further. So there are 3 degrees. First one is positive degree. What is positive degree? The simple form of adjective, that is called positive degree. No, in positive degree, no comparison will be done. So that is called positive degree, which is having the original form of the adjective. For example, Charu is a tall girl. Tall is the original form of adjective. And Charu is not compared with any other girl. So that is positive degree. In positive degree, no comparison is done and the adjective is put in its original form only. Two more examples are given. Raju is a smart boy. How he is smart? And Raju is not compared with any other boy, and smart is the original form of adjective. Next is, Amrita's bag is heavy. How is the Amrita's bag? Heavy. So that is adjective and it is in its original form. And Amrita's bag is not compared with any other thing or any other noun. So that is called positive degree, when there is no comparison and the adjective is in its original form. Second one is comparative degree. What is comparative degree? Here you can see when two nouns are compared with each other, that is called comparative degree. When two nouns are compared with each other having common adjective, so that is called comparative degree of adjective, in that the form of adjective will change. The form of the adjective that help us to compare two noun is known as comparative degree. We usually use then. How can you identify that it is comparative degree? When we compare two things, usually we use then for comparison, after the comparative form of adjective. So after the comparative form of adjective, we will use then to show that it is comparative degree. And second thing, that two nouns will be compared having common quality, common adjective. So in this way you can identify that this is comparative degree, when two nouns are compared and when after the adjective then is used, that is the sign that it is comparative degree of adjective. Next is, here some examples are given. Let us see these examples. Shilpa is taller than Charu. First thing, that Shilpa is compared with Charu. And second thing, the common quality between them, Shilpa and Charu, the common quality between them is their height. Tall, how tall they are. Okay, so comparison is done between Shilpa and Charu about their height. And in the comparison, Shilpa has more height than Charu. So the sentence will be written as, Shilpa is taller than Charu. When you see then, that means it is comparative degree, and then is used just after the comparative adjective. And how the form of adjective will change in comparative degree? Here you can see that the original form of adjective is tall. When you use comparative degree, it will change into taller. So in this way, the forms changes according to the degree. In positive degree, the adjective will be in its original form. In comparative degree, its form will change. And also in superlative degree, the form of adjective will change. How it will change, that we will see in detail later on. So how can you identify the comparative degree? When two nouns are compared. And second thing, when you see then after the adjective, that is comparative degree. And both the noun will have one common quality. Comparison is only made when the things are having one thing in common. When the nouns are having one thing in common, then only the comparison can be done. Next one is superlative degree. In superlative degree, three or more nouns are compared, and in that the one who is better than all other options, that is the superlative degree of comparison. So the form of adjective that help us to compare more than two nouns, that means three or more nouns, that is known as superlative degree. How can you identify the superlative degree? When you see the before the superlative form of adjective. So when you see before the adjective the is placed, that is the sign of superlative degree of adjective. So here some examples are given. Let's see these examples. Jyoti is the tallest girl in our class. So in my class there are many students. So I am comparing Jyoti with many students. That means more than two nouns are comparing. So in that superlative degree is used. And second thing, how can you identify? The is given before the superlative degree of adjective. So when you see the before the superlative degree of adjective, that is superlative degree. And when you see then after the adjective, after the comparative form of adjective, that is called comparative degree. So in this way you can identify the degree of comparison in the sentence. Next one, Kamal is the smartest in the group. When group is considered, that means more than two person will be there. So more than two person are compared with Kamal. So when you compare more than two nouns, that is superlative degree. Second thing here, you can see before adjective the is placed. So by this you can identify that this is superlative degree. And here you can see also the form of adjective has been change. The original form is smart. In superlative degree, it has been changed as smartest. So, in this way, the form of adjective will change according to the degree. In positive degree, it will be in original form. In comparative degree and superlative degree, the form of adjective will change. How it will change? That we will see in this table. Mostly, when you convert the adjective in comparative degree or superlative degree, you have to add er and est after the adjective. Clear? Mostly er and est is added to convert the adjective, convert the form of adjective. If you are converting it to comparative degree, then you will add er. And if the adjective is being converted into superlative degree, then you have to add est. Let's see some examples. Fast, that is in positive degree. In comparative degree, we have to add er. So it will become faster. Er is used after the adjective. So in this way, it will change in comparative degree. To change in superlative degree, we will add est in the original form. Okay. If you want to convert it into comparative degree, add er. If you want to convert it into superlative degree, add est. So it will become fast, faster, fastest. Then great, er is added in comparative degree. It will become greater. And in superlative degree, est will be added. It will become greatest. Great, greater, greatest. Long, longer, longest. Short, shorter, shortest. So in this way, you have to add er and est after the adjective to convert the form into comparative and superlative degree. Next is when the adjective is ending with e, when e is already there at the end. So you will not add e again. Instead of that, what will you do? Not, you will not add er, but as e is already there at the end, so you will add only r and st. Okay, as e is already there at the end of the adjective, you will add only r and st. Let's see the example. Brave. E is already there at the end, so you will add only r for converting into comparative degree. It will become braver. And to convert it into superlative degree, add only st, so it will become bravest. Cute, cuter, cutest. Large, larger, largest. Rare, rarer, rarest. When e is already at the end of the spelling, at the end of adjective, you will not add e again, but you will add only r and st to convert it into comparative degree and superlative degree. Now, third rule is, if the adjective is ending with y, so what will you do for changing it into comparative degree and superlative degree? You will remove y with I and then you will add er for converting into comparative degree and est for converting into superlative degree. Okay, so y will be replaced with I, and then for comparative degree add er, for superlative degree add est. Let's see the example now. Busy. Y will be removed with I and it will become busier, busiest. BUSY will change into BUSIER, busier in comparative degree. BUSIEST, busiest in superlative degree. Happy will become happier. Y will be replaced with I and then ER will be added. In comparative degree, it will become happier. In superlative degree, it will become happiest. Pretty, prettier, prettiest. Tiny, tinier, tiniest. Only y is replaced with I and then you have to add er in comparative degree, est in superlative degree. So, most commonly when you want to convert the form of adjective into comparative degree, you will add er, and if you want to convert the form of adjective in superlative degree, you will add est. That is mostly used. Okay, not every time, but mostly it is used. Next is, when there is only one syllable in the spelling. One syllable, that means having one vowel. Here you can see in the fit only I, one vowel is used. Hot, only one vowel, O is used. Thin, only one vowel, I is used. Wet, only one vowel, E is used. So when you see that the adjective is having only one vowel, so at that time, you will add the last letter twice. Okay? For example, if big is given, that means only one vowel is there. So that is called one syllable. So in that place, we will add the last letter again. And we will double the last letter. B-I-G-G-E-R or E. S-T. So in this way, when one syllable adjective is given, so at that time the last letter will be doubled, and to convert it into comparative degree you will add er, to convert it into superlative degree you will add est. Let us see the example now. Fit. In that, only one vowel is given, I. So, the last letter is T, that will be double. F-I-double-T-E-R, fitter in comparative degree. And in superlative degree, it will become F-I-double-T-E-S-T, fittest. Next one, hot. Here also you can see only one vowel is used, O. So, the last letter will be double. H-O-double-T-E-R, hotter. And H-O-double-T-E-S-T, hottest. Thin. Here also only one vowel is given. So, the last letter will be double. T-H-I-double-N-E-R, thinner in comparative degree. And in superlative degree, it will become T-H-I-double-N-E-S-T, thinnest. E-R and E-S-T will be added. And last one is wet. Here also one vowel is given, E, so the last letter will be double. W-E-double-T-E-R, wetter. Wetter yane zyada gila. Wet yane gila, wetter yane zyada gila. So wetter will be used in comparative degree, and wettest, W-E-T-E-S-T, wettest will be used in superlative degree. So in this way, the forms of adjectives will change. Keep in mind, in only one syllable, when it has only single vowel, when one syllable is given, that means the spelling or the adjective is having only one vowel, at that time you will double the last letter. Okay? Here the meaning of syllable is given. Syllable, that means a word or part of a word that has only one vowel sound. For example, the word sun has one vowel syllable, whereas planet has two syllables. So when you see one vowel syllable, then you will add the last letter again. That means you will double the last letter. And then you have to add ER for comparative degree, EST for superlative degree. Now, there are some more adjectives which are having suffix added at the end. See here, in beautiful, F-U-L, suffix is added. In comfortable, able, suffix is added. In dangerous, O-U-L, suffix is added. In peaceful, F-U-L, suffix is added. So when you see the adjective is having already suffix is added in that, so then you will not add ER and EST to convert it into comparative degree and superlative degree. What will you do? Instead of adding ER and EST, you will add more and most before the adjective. So in this way, when suffix is already added in the adjective, to convert the form of adjective, you will add more and most before the adjective. Let's see now. First one is beautiful. F-U-L suffix is added. So here, to convert it into comparative degree, we will add more before the adjective. It will become more beautiful in comparative degree, and in superlative degree, it will become most beautiful. Comfortable, able suffix is added. So then, in comparative degree, we will add more comfortable, and in superlative degree, we will add most, it will become most comfortable. Next is dangerous, O-U-S suffix is added. So then, in comparative degree, we will add more, it will become more dangerous, and in superlative degree, most will be added, it will become most dangerous. Again, I am repeating, when suffix is added, you will not add ER and EST after the adjective. Instead of that, to convert in comparative degree, add more. To convert in superlative degree, you will add most. Last one, peaceful. In comparative degree, it will become more peaceful. And in superlative degree, it will become most peaceful, as F-U-L, full suffix is added in the adjective. Now, there are some words for which there is no particular rule. In that, you have to learn the form of degrees, the form of adjective. So there is no particular rule. So you have to just learn these words. Let's see these words. Good. In comparative degree, it will change in better. In superlative degree, it will change in best. Many change in more for comparative degree. For superlative degree, it will be most. Little, less, least. Then bad, worse, worst. So in this way, these words will change according to the form of degree. But there is no particular formula or rule to change these forms. You have to learn these forms only. So now, with this, all the rules regarding the changes of degrees have been explained. Now I hope that this explanation will be useful to you. After this, we will do the exercise. Here the explanation completes. Let us revise these rules again. First rule is to convert the form of adjective into comparative degree, add er, and to convert the form of adjective into superlative degree, add est. Second rule is when the adjective is ending with e, the ending letter is e, you will add only r and st to convert it into comparative degree and superlative degree. Next is when the adjective is ending with y, in comparative degree and superlative degree, y will be replaced with I and then you will add er to convert it into comparative degree and to convert it into superlative degree, add iest. When the last ending letter of adjective is y, replace the y with I and then add er and est to convert it into comparative degree and superlative degree. Next is when the adjective is of one syllable, that means it is having only one vowel, then you will have to double the last letter. Okay? When the adjective is having only one vowel, then you have to double the last letter and then add er and est to convert it into comparative degree and superlative degree. And when the adjective is having already added suffix, when the suffix is already added in the adjective, so after that you cannot add er and est to the adjective. So what will you do? When suffix is already there, you will add more and most before the adjective. Okay? So here in comparative degree and superlative degree, it will become, if the adjective is given in positive degree, beautiful, in comparative degree it will become more beautiful, and in superlative degree it will become most beautiful. So more and most will be added before the adjective when suffix is already added in the adjective. So there we will not use er and est, instead of that we will use more and most before the adjective. And last one is, there are some adjectives which are not having any particular rule for changing the degrees. So you have to learn their forms. These are as given: good, better, best, many, more, most, little, less, least, bad, worse, worst. So these are some of the adjectives which are not having any particular rule for changing the degrees. So with this, we have revised all the rules to change the degrees of adjective. Now we will do the comparison. Now we will do the exercise of degree of comparison to check how much we have understood. So the first exercise is given. In that, you can see three columns are given: positive degree, comparative degree, and superlative degree. In positive degree, the form of adjective does not change, it will be as it is, as the comparison is not made in positive degree. So when the comparison will be made in comparative degree and superlative degree, the form of adjective will change. How it will change, that you have to write here according to the rules. First one, black. In that we will add er, blacker. And in superlative degree, we will add est, it will become blackest. Next is smooth. In comparative degree, ER will be added smoother. In superlative degree, EST will be added, it will become smoothest. Smooth, smoother, smoothest. Next is enjoyable. Here you can see able. Suffix is already added. So we will not add ER and EST. Instead of that, we will put more and most before the adjective. It will become more enjoyable and most enjoyable. Next is dirty. Here you can see the adjective is ending with Y. So Y will be replaced with I, and then we will add ER to convert it into comparative degree, and we will add EST to convert it into superlative degree. So it will become dirty, dirtier, and dirtiest. Next is cheerful. Here FUL suffix is added. So we will not add ER and EST. Instead of that, we will put more and most. So it will become more cheerful and most cheerful. Next is sad and bad. Here you can see in sad only one vowel is used. So that is one syllable. In that we will double the last letter, and it will become sadder and saddest. After doing the last letter double, after writing the last letter twice, you will add ER for comparative degree and EST for superlative degree. So it will become sad, sadder, and saddest. Next is bad. There is no particular rule to change this adjective. So you have to learn the form of degrees. For bad, in comparative degree, it will use bad, worse, and worst. In positive degree, bad will be there. In comparative degree, worse will be there. And in superlative degree, worst will be there. And there is no particular rule for the change of this adjective. Next is interesting. Here also, ing is already added. That means suffix is already added. So what will we do? We will add more to convert it into comparative degree. It will become more interesting. And to convert it into superlative degree, we will add most. So it will become most interesting. When suffix is already added after the when suffix is already added in the adjective, so then we will use more and most to convert the degrees. In the next exercise, here fill in the blanks with the correct form of the adjective given in the bracket. So here the original form of adjective is given, and you have to convert the form of adjective according to the form of degree. How will you come to know that which degree is used and in which form you have to convert the adjective? So for that, as I told you, some signs you have to remember. Let us see the first question. I am dash in playing hockey than football. So here hockey and football, two nouns are compared, and you can see than here. So when than is given, that means the comparison is done between two things. When the two nouns are compared, that means it is comparative degree. And to convert the adjective in comparative degree, what you have to do? Here you can see ed suffix is added in the adjective. So you will add more to convert it into comparative degree. And it will become more interesting. Next is, my sister's drawing is dash than mine. So here mine and my sister's drawing is compared. two nouns are compared, and second thing you can see then. That means it is comparative. So comparative form of good will be better. Next is India is a dash country than Mexico. India and Mexico are compared. Two things are compared, then is given. That means it is comparative degree. How will you change the form of adjective? In comparative degree, it is one syllable. That means one vowel adjective. One syllable adjective is given. So you will double the last letter and then you will add er. So it will become bigger in comparative degree. Next is, dogs are said to be the dash of all animals. The is given, that means it is superlative degree. When before the adjective, the is given, that means you have to use superlative degree. Faithful is given, as you can see, F-U-L, full. Suffix is already added in the adjective, so you will not add er and est. Instead of that, to convert it into superlative degree, you will add most. Most faithful. So the sentence will be, dogs are said to be the most faithful of all animals. Here again you can see two or more than two things are compared. Animals, that means more than two animals are compared. That is why it is superlative degree and the is used before the adjective. So it is it also signifies that it is superlative degree. Now to convert the adjective into superlative degree, as you can see here, F-U-L, suffix is given. So we will not add E-S-T after the adjective, but instead of that, we will add most before the adjective. So it will become most faithful. That is the superlative degree. That is the form of superlative degree adjective. Next is, Rajasthan has a dash climate than Kerala. Then is given, and Rajasthan and Kerala are being compared. Two nouns are being compared, then is given. That means it is comparative degree. Now you have to change the form of adjective. Y is given, so you will replace Y with I, and to convert it into comparative degree, you will add er. So it will become driver, driver. So in this way, the form of degree will be changed. And how will you come to know about the degree? When you see this words like than and the. So with that, you will come to know that which kind of degree is given. If you can't see than and the in the sentence, that means that is positive degree and no comparison is made. So there you will use the original form of adjective, as it is positive degree. When comparison is made, then only we have to change the form of adjective. Otherwise, in positive degree, the form of adjective does not change because comparison is not made. Last one is, platinum is the dash precious dash of all metals. All metals are compared. That means more than two metals are compared. That is superlative degree. Second thing, before adjective, the is given. So it clarifies that this is superlative degree. Now here you can see precious, O-U-S, prefix, O-U-S suffix is already added in the adjective. So we will not add E-S-T to convert it into superlative degree. Instead of that, what will we do? We will add most before the adjective. Okay? So when the is given and more than two nouns are compared, that is superlative degree, to convert in superlative degree. As in adjective, suffix is already added, so we will not add est. We will add most to compare, to convert the adjective into superlative degree. Okay? So in this way, the changes will be made in the form of adjectives. First, you have to identify the degree of comparison in the sentence, and then according to the rules, you have to change the form of adjective according to the degree. Now the last exercise is, Complete the story, fill in the blanks with the correct form of adjective. Let us start this exercise. Alka's cat gave birth to a litter of cute kittens. A litter of cute kittens. That means there are more than one kittens. She asked her friend Farhan if she wanted to take one of the kittens. One of the kittens, that means among all the kittens, if she wants to take one. Farah asked her mother. She promised to be a dash girl. Here you can see then and the is not used, and she is not compared with anyone else. So here we will use positive degree. Good will be written as it is. In positive degree, the form of adjective does not change. And take care of the kittens in the possible way. Here you can see before the adjective the is given. So we will use superlative degree. The superlative form of adjective. The superlative form of good is best. Next is Farah's mother gave her the permission. She gave Farah a dash basket. She gave Farah a dash basket. The basket is not compared with anything else. So here, as no comparison is made, that means it is superlative degree, it is positive degree. As you can see, then and the both are not used. And no comparison is made, that means it is positive degree. In positive degree, adjective will be in its original form. So small will be written again as it is. And a few towel in which to bring the kittens, to bring the kitten home. Because she is taking one kitten only. So that is why there is no comparison. And here the sentence said, when you see end, that means the first sentence is ended. So for first sentence you have to put the adjective. Now what happens? On reaching Alka's house, Farah saw five little kittens. That means more than one. Five little kittens. She loved the one of them. The is given, that means it is superlative degree. The form of adjective is 9. You have to change it into superlative degree. To change it into superlative degree, first thing, when the adjective end with Y, you will remove Y with I, and then to change it into superlative degree as the is given, you will add EST. Tinest. So here the spelling will become tinest. She loved the tiniest one of them, the smallest one of them. It had a dash black patches on its forehead. Only one kitten is talked about. One noun is talked about. That means there are no more than one noun. So there is no comparison. And when there is no comparison, that means it is positive degree. In positive degree, the form of adjective does not change. So here we will write the adjective as it is. It had a cute black patch on its forehead. What it had? A cute black patch. Only one. A is given. So when there is only one noun, that means it is of positive degree. It also seemed to be dash of the lot. To be the is given. Before adjective, the is given, that means it is superlative degree, and of the lot is given, lot that means more than two. So here you can understand when more than two things, when more than two nouns are compared, that means it is superlative degree. And the is given, again it signifies that it is superlative degree. And when superlative degree is given, you will use the superlative form of this adjective. So here you can see naughty is given and the adjective is ending with y. Y will be replaced with I, and then to convert it into superlative degree, you will add est. Okay, so it will become naughtiest. N-A-U-G-H-T. Y will be replaced with I, and then we will add est to convert it into superlative degree, because the is given. The shows when before adjective the is given, it shows that it is superlative degree. So to convert it into superlative degree, est will be added and y will be replaced with I. It will become, it also seemed to be the naughtiest of the lot. Farah decided to name the kitten Patchy and brought it at home. So in this way, you have to identify the degree and then accordingly you have to change. If only one noun, if you see a or an, that means only one noun is talked about, that means it is of positive degree. And if you see then, that means two nouns are being compared, that means it is comparative degree. And if you see the, that means more than two nouns are compared and it is superlative degree. When the is given before the adjective, then it is superlative degree and more than two nouns are being compared. When then is given, that means two nouns are compared and it is comparative degree. And when you see a or an, that means only one noun is talked about. So there is no comparison and it is called positive degree. In positive degree, the adjective will be in its original form. There will be no change in the form of adjective. If it is in comparative degree, if it is in comparative degree, you will add more or er. Er will be added after the adjective, more will be added before the adjective. If it is the, that means superlative degree, in superlative degree, you will add most and est. Est will be added after the adjective and most will be added before the adjective. Okay? So in this way, you have to identify the adjective, and after identifying, you have to convert the form of adjective according to the rules. Now we have completed the explanation and exercise. So let us quickly revise it again. First thing, that degrees of comparison is the second step of adjective, in that the two or more nouns are compared and with the comparison the form of adjective changes. That is called degree of comparison. And there are three degrees: positive, comparative and superlative. In positive, no comparison is done, only one noun is talked about. So the adjective will be in its original form. In comparative degree, two nouns will be compared, so the form of adjective will change. How will you identify that it is comparative degree? When you see two nouns are being compared and when you see then, T-H-A-N, then. So it is comparative degree and you have to change the form of adjective into comparative degree. How will you change the form of adjective into comparative degree? By adding er at the end of adjective or by adding more before the adjective. Next is superlative degree. When more than two nouns are being compared, So that is superlative degree. Okay, when three or more nouns are being compared, that is superlative degree. How will you come to know that it is superlative degree? When you see before the adjective the is given, so it is superlative degree. How will you convert the adjective in superlative degree? By adding est after the adjective, or by adding most before the adjective. According to the rule, you have to change the form of adjective. So after identifying the form of degree, that is, if a or an is given, that means one noun is talked about, that is positive degree. If two nouns are being compared, that means then will be given, that is comparative degree. If the is given, that means more than three nouns are being compared, that is superlative degree. When you see the, it is superlative degree. When you see then, it is comparative degree. When you see a or an, it is positive degree. Again, I am repeating. A or an, that means positive degree. Then, that means comparative degree. And the, that means superlative degree. So, according to the form of degree, you have to change the adjective. In positive degree, the adjective will be in its original form. In comparative degree, you will add more before the adjective, or you will add er after the adjective. In superlative degree, you will add most before the adjective, and you will add est after the adjective. So in this way, you have to identify the adjective and you have to change the form of adjective according to the degrees of comparison. And the degrees of comparison are used to explain the adjective or to explain the quality of noun more clearly and to emphasize on the quality of the noun. Okay, so for making it more clearly understandable, the quality of noun more clearly understandable, degrees of comparison is used. There are three degrees: positive, comparative, superlative. And in this way, you can identify the degrees and change the form of adjective according to the degrees. And in this way, adjective can be placed more effectively. So this was the topic of degrees of comparison, which is the second step of adjective. Here, the explanation and exercise completes. With this, we come to an end of this video, and now I hope that this topic is clear to you. Now we will meet in the next video with new topic. Till then, take care of yourself, be safe, and keep on learning. Thanks for being with me. See you.